There's a growing percentage of the population who has a deep and grave concern about the possibility of the United States government turning its military and all of its might against the civilian population. In this video, we're going to look at not necessarily the possibility of that type of event happening, but of the likely outcome.
Gold looks higher, currencies look weaker.
More about this currency crisis you see erupting. What does that assume about what's going to happen to the dollar?
Well, it assumes that the dollar will utterly get destroyed and become virtually worthless. I don't know how that inevitably resolves itself. It may resolve itself in some type of a global currency crisis. And then if the global currency crisis unfolds, then inevitably you get an alignment under a global world government, a new global currency, and a new world order.
Growing debate in Washington following reports that some U.S. senators are now considering an immigration bill that would force all U.S. workers to carry around biometric ID cards. Well, it is an idea that is now raising some serious concerns among privacy advocates.
Through the advancing market of biometrics, technology that uses physiological and behavioral recognition to identify people. A system touted as a national security necessity is being used to build a database where the biometric identity of millions of Americans will be gathered and stored.
We really need to attack this in a comprehensive kind of way, not some knee-jerk reaction like sticking something in someone's finger to verify who they are and whether or not they can be employed in this country.
The U.S. Department of Homeland Security has been buying up massive amounts of ammunition. Americans are wondering why.
Do you think this is a sign that they're preparing for some sort of mass civil unrest?
If you look at what the Department of Homeland Security has been purchasing over the last year, it comes out to like 1.6 billion rounds of ammunition, more than 7,000 fully automatic assault weapons, 2,700 MRAP type vehicles, and now drones. Those are instruments of war. Department of Homeland Security's, who are they going to fight a war?
So again, this is just changing the culture, bringing all of this in. But I want to play from a promotional video put out by Guardian Centers. Some of the video for you right now, and we've been showing some of it as well while I've been talking here, where, again, interspersed with the firefighters and other legitimate things, it shows the military rounding people up, and every one of them is black. Now, that's newsworthy right there. I've been to these drills where they all are farmers, wearing John Deere caps and stuff, saying, you know, you can't take my land, you can't take my guns. Very scary stuff. But it was a black farmer, white farmer, Hispanic farmer. Little extra black folks. I mean, obviously saying, oh, it's for Al-Qaeda, that's a bad group, but it's really for all Americans. Oh, well, blacks, you know, they're kind of looked down on quietly by some people. Oh, look, it's for blacks, so it's okay. And it's military and white guys, white civilians looking on as groups of blacks tump over cars and, you know, get rounded up and thrown behind barbed wire. I mean, this is pretty outrageous. But don't expect Jesse Jackson or Al Sharpton, the race baiters, to say anything. They're just there to create more racial division in this country, not actually point out that there's preparation to target black communities, which are under gun control like Chicago and has the highest crime rate in the world, which are under the fake drug war that's bringing down Chicago, just like Mexico's collapsing. It's the policies that are causing this cultural collapse. But here's some of the promotional video hiding in plain view. Let me show you just a few more articles that will give you a larger picture as we connect the dots here. And then we're going to go to Staff Sergeant retired Joe Biggs to specifically analyze some of this video that shows regular Army engaging in civilian suppression, basically. No other way to describe it.
Know what it's like to lose. To feel so desperately that you're right, yet to fail all the same. Dread it. Run from it. Destiny still arrives.
Evacuate the city. Engage all defenses. And get this man a shield.
Fun isn't something one considers when balancing the universe. But this does put a smile on my face.